While Anne was not beautiful in any strictly defined sense of the word, she possessed a certain evasive charm and distinction of appearance that left beholders with a pleasurable sense of satisfaction in that softly rounded girlhood of hers, with all its strongly felt potentialities. Those who knew Anne best felt, without realizing that they felt it, that her greatest attraction was the aura of possibility surrounding her, the power of future development that was in her. She seemed to walk in an atmosphere of things about to happen. As they picked, Carlotta the Fourth confided to Anne her fears regarding Miss Lavendar. The warm-hearted little handmaiden was honestly worried over her adored mistress's condition. "Miss Lavendar isn't well, Miss Shirley, ma'am. I am sure she isn't, though she never complains. She hasn't seemed like herself this long while, ma'am, not since that day you and Paul were here together before. I feel sure she caught cold that night, ma'am. After you and him had gone, she went out and walked in the garden for long after dark, with nothing but a little shawl on her. There was a lot of snow on the walks, and I feel sure she got a chill, ma'am. Ever since then I've noticed her acting tired and lonesome-like. She don't seem to take an interest in anything, ma'am. She never pretends company's coming, nor fixes up for it, nor nothing, ma'am. It's only when you come she seems to chirk up a bit. And the worst sign of all, Miss Shirley, ma'am"—Carlotta the Fourth lowered her voice as if she were about to tell some exceedingly weird and awful symptom indeed—"is that she never gets cross now when I breaks things. Why, Miss Shirley, ma'am, yesterday I broke her green and yeller bowl that's always stood on the bookcase. Her grandmother brought it out from England, and Miss Lavendar was awful choice of it. I was dusting it just as careful, Miss Shirley, ma'am, and it slipped out so fashion afore I could grab hold of it, and broke into about 40 million pieces. I tell you, I was sorry and scared. I thought Miss Lavendar would scold me awful, ma'am, and I'd rather she had than take it the way she did. She just come in and hardly looked at it and said, 'It's no matter, Carlotta, take up the pieces and throw them away.' Just like that, Miss Shirley, ma'am, take up the pieces and throw them away, as if it wasn't her grandmother's bull from England. Oh, she isn't well, and I feel awful bad about it. She's got nobody to look after her but me.